The TN's channel.
Alright, my channel. Welcome guys, introducing myself, I'm TN. And this is Han, as known as my sister. Welcome Han.
Anyway, what is our topic today?
Our topic will be about the article, Want Kids to Become Scientists? Don't Arrest Them for Experimenting by Liz Dwyer.
I see. Now tell me, what is it about?
Alright, this article is about a 16-year-old girl, Kara Wilmot, who got arrested for mixing toilet bowl cleaner and aluminum foil in a bottle, and it created a relatively tame explosion.
Hold on, why did she do that experiment?
Alright, I forgot. It's because of a company to beat surrogates through a project called STEAM Carnival. This is a project to get children into science, technology, engineering, and math.
Oh, go on.
Not only she got arrested, but also charged as an adult, and she got expelled by her school.
That's weird.
Also, deep sea biologist Andrew David Deller and biologist Dan Lee had the same thinking. This story is about race.
Oh yeah? That's not really fair. I hate racism. Anyways, what do you think the point of this article?
According to Dwyer, she said this kind of experiment have already done countless times by the STEAM Carnival folks. She also said instead of encouraging her future in chemistry, the school also expelled her. Based on deep sea biologist Andrew David Feller, he was sure that educators know how to respond to inquisitive, even reckless inquisitive students, and that response is never pleasant.
What is your opinion? Do you think it's fair?
Of course no, I don't think it's fair at all. Would the situation change if she's a white girl? Biologist Daniel Lee also said, I can't name a single scientist or engineer who hadn't blown up, ripped apart, disassembled something at home, or otherwise caused a big ruckus at school in the name of curiosity, myself included. And was it necessary to call the police? One thing that I keep on wondering about this is why they charged her as an adult. She's 16. At the end of the article, Dwyer also gave in. It's encouraging to see the scientific community is also standing up and supporting Wilmot with the science is not a crime hashtag on social media.
Oh wow, I totally agree with you. No more and no less.
Anyways, let's get going. Bye guys!